things that I like people to understand is, why does bariatric surgery work? And there's complete confusion out there, not amongst only lay people, but physicians in general don't understand. So what happens when we do bariatric surgery, and I'll speak specifically of the sleeve gastrectomy, or otherwise known as the sleeve, that has a tremendous impact on gut hormones. Those are hormones produced in the GI tract that are totally changed after a sleeve, and they alter a patient's hunger and cravings. Most patients have no hunger, and all of their cravings that kept them from losing weight in the past are shut down. So patients no longer have that cravings for chocolate, for candy, for salty, for bread, carb cravings. So those things go away. In addition to, of course, with a sleeve, you take a football-sized stomach and make it more banana-sized. So by getting rid of cravings, hunger, and shrinking capacity, patients are set up to win and lose weight. Compare that to a diet. Everyone comes in and they think, I've failed so many diets, maybe this is one more thing I'm going to fail. I say no, because diets don't do the things that bariatric surgery does. Diets have no impact on hunger, no impact on cravings, no impact on capacity. So it's just suck it up and do your best. And hunger and cravings are two of the most powerful forces in the universe. And long term, they win. I mean, I don't know anyone who's lost 100 pounds on a diet and kept it off. The theory today on why bariatrics works and other things don't work is something called the set point theory. As we gain weight, our brain has this set point that's constantly growing as patients gain weight or as people gain weight in their lives. And so your body comes to accept your present state as something that is normal and should be defended. Meaning if you gain weight and go up to 250 pounds, it's like a one-way street. There's no way back because your brain shifts the set point up to 250 pounds. So when you say, okay, that's it, I'm gonna lose weight. So you go on a diet. What happens? You drop your calories and your hunger and craving hormones skyrocket. So suddenly all you can think about is food every second. Not only that, you know, you may lose 10, 12 pounds and then you hit a brick wall. That's because metabolism then drops down, says that's it. It is defending that set point that they think your brain thinks is normal. It's not normal at all, but because of today's modern society with limited activities and all the engineered food we have in front of us and easy access, that's what happens. So as people gain weight, like I said, it's a one-way street. You're not going back. Not easily anyway. And so you may have small gains, but because of that set point and your body vigorously defending that weight and it wanting to be there, it is a very difficult battle for patients. So everybody comes in and tells me the yo-yo story. I lost a little weight, I lost 10 pounds, I don't need anything, but I can't lose any more weight. And that's because that body is trying to defend that weight. What bariatric surgery does is lowers your set point. It does that by totally altering those hunger and craving hormones and altering capacity. So once again, diets don't alter set points because they don't affect the hunger and craving hormones and they don't affect capacity. So they're short-term solutions to a lifelong problem. That's not to say that someone that's 10, 15, 20 pounds overweight, you should be able to lose that and maintain it. But once people get 75, 100 pounds overweight, it is virtually unheard of. I mean, I will challenge anyone, find me the person that lost the weight and kept it off long term.